If you don't have a personal portfolio, your GitHub profile may serve as the first impression you make on potential employers and anybody who's interested in your work. By default, our profiles are kind of boring and blank, but in reality, they are a canvas that we can paint and show our personalities as well as our work. So today, let's make over my GitHub profile. Hey, I'm Bree and welcome back to my channel. I hope that you guys are having an awesome day. And if this is your first time seeing me, hi, I'm Bree and I am super happy to have you here. So I'm really excited about today's video because, like I said a few seconds ago, I am going to be giving my GitHub profile a makeover. I've been using a GitHub Enterprise profile for most of my career so far, so I didn't really have the opportunity to make it over like I wanted to, but I have that opportunity now. So today, that's exactly what we're gonna do, and I'm also going to talk about a few tips and tricks that you could use on your profile as well. So you don't have to be a designer or spend hours tweaking code like I used to on MySpace. But there's a few things everybody can do to take their profile from being sort of the same profile that everybody has to very individualized and more representative of your personality. So before I get into it, I do want to let you know that there are timestamps in the description in case you are looking for a specific chapter or you are coming back to watch this video as you are making over your GitHub profile. So first, we'll talk about some general tips that I think everybody could use to add a little bit of sparkle to their profile, and then we will walk through creating the actual README that is going to be displayed on your GitHub profile itself. So in terms of general tips and personalization, the first thing is, and it sounds simple, but add a profile picture. All of the avatars kind of look the same, they're really blocky, and I can't always tell them apart. Maybe that's a personal problem, I don't know. But you can add a picture of yourself, of course, or anything that represents you. The second thing is giving yourself a little bio. Tell people who you are or tell them what you are currently working on. And the third general tip is to customize your pins. This is something I'm going to work on once I have a few more repos, but you can customize the pins that people see when they first come to your profile. I know personally when I'm first working on a project, it's kind of messy and I'm just getting everything together, but show people where your best work is and what that work is. And now we're going to get into the section where we are going to create our profile README. And this is the fun part. This is where you can really show and tell people who you are as a person, also with the work that you're doing, but mainly the personality behind the projects. Think about talking about things within tech, but also don't be afraid to add things that aren't necessarily in the realm of tech. You can talk about what your goals are, the work that you're currently doing, what communities you're part of. You can also talk about your tech stack, the languages or technologies that you use, and make sure to link to your blogs, your socials, and any press that you have as well. And for an extra little touch, you can also add banners, graphics, and badges as well. So the first thing we need to do is create the repo that's responsible for housing our profile README. The repo that's going to contain our profile's README is a special repo, and when you're creating it, you must name it after your GitHub username. After you name it, be sure to make it public, and then you can also select the option to add the README file directly in the configuration. So after you do this, you'll notice that you have basically a blank repo that just has a README file. And what we can do is edit this directly in GitHub by selecting the file and then choosing edit, or you can clone the repo and edit it in your favorite text editor. And that's exactly what I'm gonna do. So by default, our README is going to use Markdown, which is like a more human readable markup language, but it also has full HTML support. And I've included resources below if you're new to Markdown and want some cheat sheets. So here's the really fun part. It's going to be the content of your README. This is your profile, so add whatever you'd like, but at the very least, you should have a few sentences about yourself. If you'd like to add graphics, just know that you don't have to be a designer or illustrator. I'm definitely not. My default is always Canva. I just created a banner that was 1,280 pixels by 640, added a background and a tiny illustration as well. They also have tons of images and icons as well. So when I was doing research, I personally found it a lot of fun to look at tons of READMEs and determine the layout that I wanted and sort of what content that I wanted in mine. And if you need a little bit of inspiration, I'm going to go ahead and leave some of my favorite links to READMEs below. So after you're content and happy with the content of your README, you can go ahead and commit the changes you made and see what a difference it makes on your profile. Whether you spent 15 or 20 minutes creating a simple but elegant README, or you spent an afternoon creating and gathering the right graphics like I did, adding a README to your profile can make such a difference. And after we have committed our README, the next thing that we're gonna do is add a social preview. So this is one last customization that can really make a big difference. The social preview is what's going to be shown when you link to your GitHub profile outside of GitHub. I'm fairly lazy, so I just decided to use the same banner that I used on my profile README. Again, something simple, but definitely pushes the experience of your profile to the next level. So I personally found updating my README from being blank to being not so blank a really fun afternoon activity. So I would love to know, have you customized yours or will you be customizing yours? And if you are in need of some inspiration or some resources for Markdown or the actual documentation that GitHub has posted for creating fun READMEs, I've left them in the description below. I hope that you guys have enjoyed this video and sort of making over my GitHub profile with me. And if you did enjoy this video, please feel free to like and subscribe. And if you subscribe, make sure that you turn on notifications to be notified whenever I post a video. But until then, thank you guys so very much for watching, and I will see you next time.